Very good afternoon to all dignitaries present on dais and all my fellow student managers. I, Ronak Pathari, student manager of Sri Balaji Society, feeling privileged to introduce you all a very illustrious personality, Mr. Rajesh Jain. Mr. Rajesh Jain is currently head of HR for Financial and Corporate Services at SREI. Mr. Rajesh has over 26 years of diverse experience across industries such as renewable energy power, office automation, document technology, and financial services. Sir is an MBHR from ICFI and B honors in electronic and telecommunication from Government Engineering College, Ujjain. Sir has worked with organizations like Suzlon Energy, Eaton Corporation, and Xerox India before joining SREI. Mr. Rajesh served in various capacities and in diverse functions such as sales, technical services, corporate strategy planning, finance, and human resource development. Sir is an experienced examiner of Medwich Business Excellence Model and a trainer on varied subjects such as Six Sigma, Balanced Scorecard, Competency-Based Assessment, and Leadership Development. Mr. Rajesh is an avid runner and has completed more than 20 half marathons across India. Now, I'd like to invite Mr. Rajesh to share his words of wisdom. Sir, that is all yours.
Good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon, sir.
So I feel so good when I stand on this dais. This is my second opportunity to stand here and talk to the students. You know what? For people of my age, late 40s, where at home we have teenage children, a wife full of wisdom, and in the office, whether be at home or office, nobody wants to listen to you. And when you receive such invites where you are supposed to talk, wow.
What a feeling.
So I never wanted to miss this opportunity. The only fear I have when I generally go for such occasions that I should not be boring people. So I don't know what you all expect out of this 45 minutes, 1 hour or whatever. But what I think is the only difference between your teachers, your parents and me would be my slightly different experience. You know, otherwise, the faculty, your parents, everybody is full of knowledge, wisdom. I don't know what additional I am going to share with you. But certainly, every human being goes through a different set of experience. So maybe that experience, all the mistakes which I have committed in my life, or anything which has gone right for me, you can take some clues from there. Why? Because in a place called Kathua in Jammu and Kashmir, I was at that point in time a service engineer. I had gone to repair a photocopier, I think in early 90s. So there in a old government school, I saw something written there. Hindi mein likha tha. I'm assuming everybody understands that. If somebody doesn't understand that, maybe the neighbors should help them. Usme likha tha ki janwar swabhav se seekhte hain. The animals learn by nature. I mean, that is how nobody teaches a cat to climb a tree. Nobody teaches a dog to bark, etc. They know, they do it. And the common people, aam aadmi, apni galti se seekhte hain. Isn't it? So we all learn from our mistakes. But a wise person learns from others' mistakes. So we reach here, so obviously we all are wiser people. So we will talk about some of the mistakes which we have committed, which I have committed, maybe you can learn. So we will not repeat them. So thoda sa time bachega. I mean, you will save a lot of time when you are you enter the chaos. You know, you are in a very, very regulated, structured environment today. Your school, colleges, everything is so structured, nice, beautiful. But once it is over, you know, you enter the chaos. And when you enter the chaos, you will, I mean, the struggle starts, but it is very enjoyable.
So what I thought, I actually, I was checking with Dr. Rashmi, what is the topic, how do we go about the whole interaction. So I was told that, you know, I can align my talk with the agenda of the conference, which is guiding the way to 21st century. So I was happy because, you know, this is a topic where I can speak and everything is about the guidance and everything is about the 21st century. So what I chose to do is that I have divided my presentation or my talk into two parts. One is about life. Let it be 21st century life. So, and the other part is about the work life. So I thought at this stage where I can recall when I was at a stage at which you guys are, there is a lot of anxiety inside, multiple pressure from the parents, pressure from the teachers, pressure from within that I need to do well in my studies, and then studies are fine, now I have to get some placement, do something in my life, so time to get launched. So I think you must have been receiving a lot of advice, a lot of guidance. But what is more important, especially, what we lack in India, I was speaking at some other forum also, that the students are not, there are less of right kind of counseling available for students. What to do, what not to do. In one of the conference, NESCOM conference in Chennai, last month, they did a very new thing. They invited students and they formed a panel on the stage and just everybody was sitting there and listening to them. But when I heard them, I liked the kind of confidence they had. The students were full of confidence. At our stage when we were in colleges, we could never imagine that kind of confidence unless you are fluent speaker. But those guys were full of confidence. But something which bothered me was that the kind of information about the corporate life they had was grossly wrong. So what happens is, so there are certain discounts which go on. I think I spoke about couple of them last time also. I said earlier, corporate or going outside in the work world, the world is chaotic, right? But at the same time, it is very enjoyable. And, somebody asked me, do we need to prepare our children to, or students to actually cope up with the pressures of the world outside? How do they manage the change? Etc. So my answer is that, though it is, they are two different words, but frankly speaking, no preparation is required. When I say no preparation is required, means no preparation at all. Because you have seen your parents doing that, you've seen the parents of your friends doing that. I can give you my example. I passed out from an engineering college in Ujjain. And Ujjain, even today, it's a small place, maybe some of you are from there. It's a relatively small place and it remained a small place. Our college was further in the area where no habitation was there. So we were literally in a jungle and very old-fashioned college. Apart from few books which we studied about engineering, we had no further exposure. But when I started working, we started working. I mean, it was not that it took us longer to get adjusted. I remember first day I went to the office, I wore my jeans and t-shirt. I thought that is the way we work. So first day nobody told me anything. Second day, one of my senior colleague told me that, listen, you know, as per the office norm, you should be dressed in at least shirt and pant and trousers. Next day I borrowed, and after another week I got myself a trouser and a shirt stitch. Yeah, so the words are different, but doesn't matter actually. So don't even worry about preparing for corporate. While in college, we should stay focused in actually learning what we are supposed to learn. You know, the frameworks which we can go and deploy. You know, we expect, corporate expects the new students or the new fresh graduates, postgraduates to come and add value. So you can't add value in terms of your experience. You can't add value in terms of your knowledge on the particular sector. But what you can do is you can add value by thinking differently and applying the theoretical concepts into the business situations. So most of the times, people like us who've been into a particular job for years altogether, we lose our ability to think differently. So I think there you can add a lot of value. So therefore it is important, you can do that only if you have thorough understanding of the theoretical concepts. Theoretical concepts are, they just don't come through the air. They are also based upon some practical experiences only. So therefore, I think that is what we can do in terms of preparing for the corporates. At the same time, I have seen in many colleges, which give a lot of focus on preparing students how to face interviews, right? Actually, when we interview people, first of all, it is not possible. It is not humanly possible. I had HR and I have seen, I have been doing recruitments, thousands of recruitments every year, and I have seen many experts, recruitment experts, but I am yet to come across a process, or I am yet to come across a person who can do the right kind of assessment in those 15 minutes, half an hour, 1 hour, 2 hours. So what happens? The only assessment which we are able to make during an interview is whether the person is confident, and confidence comes only with knowledge, right? So no amount of good dressing would help, no amount of actually practicing, conversation practicing would help, but the only thing which will help is how to go, so it has come. So it is all about your knowledge, and in 15 to 20 minutes or maybe half an hour, when you talk to the person sitting across the table, he or she is able to actually assess whether the person is knowledgeable or not, or eager to learn or not. I think that is something which is best to do if you think you have to prepare for interview. Otherwise, not required. Just focus whatever you are doing today. You do it well, and the interviews happen. Good, so I will now stick to my structured presentation. I'll make an attempt to be structured, though we are from a chaotic world, as I said. So, we work in a very haphazard manner. So I will talk about two things. The first is life. Yeah? So, the point I'm trying to make here is, so there is life, and life has a cycle. We all go through it. Isn't it? Is there anybody sitting in this room or you know who doesn't undergo this cycle which is depicted here? Am I right?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So having understood that we all are mortal, in the long run we all are dead. What a negative thought to start with. Nevertheless, but that is true, that is the truth. So the point I am trying to make here is work life is much smaller than the life. So life is more important than work. कोई नई चीज नहीं है, दिस इज नॉट समथिंग न्यू विच आई एम टेलिंग यू, बट देर इज अ डिफरेंस बिटवीन सेइंग इट एंड प्रैक्टिसिंग इट, राइट? आई हैव सीन वेरी फ्यू पीपल, राइट, हु लिव बाय दिस दैट नो लाइफ इज मोर इम्पोर्टेंट देन वर्क लाइफ. नाउ व्हाट इज इम्पोर्टेंट इन लाइफ? द फर्स्ट इज हेल्थ. एंड व्हेन आई से हेल्थ, सो इफ यू लुक एट दिस ट्रायंगल, इट इज a triangle with all equal sides, which means that no side is less important. So mental health, social health and physical health. So whatever you are doing today and whatever your aspirations are tomorrow, you will not be able to achieve unless you are healthy. Again, nothing new here. However, practicing is the most difficult thing here. I'll give you my own experience. A few years back I started learning to meditate. So the first thing I learned before I went into the meditation is to sit for longer hours. You will not be able to sit for longer hours unless you have a good spine. And you cannot have a good spine unless you actually do the proper exercises to actually keep your spine healthy. What I'm trying to make is that if you want to, everything is a cause and effect, if you want to do meditation, you have to be healthy. To be healthy, you have to do certain things. So it is a sequence. So similarly, if you want to do well in your life, first and foremost, focus on your health. And the other thing is, nobody else is responsible for your health. It is only you. And nobody else will help you, including your immediate family, your parents, your wife, children, your family doctor. Nobody can help you in actually getting your good health, but only you are responsible. So all your action will only result into a good health of yours. So whatever you want to do, but first and foremost, focus on your health. Ensure that you spend at least, 2 to 4 hours on your health every day. Apart from the kind of food choices you make, etc. Right? So this is the first thing to have a good life. Otherwise, good life will become a myth. Then second is self-awareness. Once we think that we are healthy, then it is important to understand yourself. Again, you will feel that we know ourselves, but believe you me, I realized what I am very late in life. So if there are people who understand themselves early in life, a magic will happen. A magic means, then the people are at peace. Once I know that I am this kind of a person, then I know I can do few things, I cannot do few things, and I will not be at unease because the kind of person I am. So I'll just give you a metaphor here. There are 4 types of people, as personal traits. The one kind who are externally influenced and role oriented are like Yudhishthir, and they are precedent, they are focused at norms, rules, hierarchy, they are governed by authority and role, and wisdom and resources which are not inside, outside, they trigger them, but they are not driven by their own feelings. These are the people, these are one type of people. Maybe some of you are you fit into that role. The other kind of people who are internally, who work on their internal skills and follow the role which they get. They are kind of people which Bhim was in Mahabharata. They are impulsive, passionate, counter-dependent, action-oriented. The range is between omnipotent to impotent, and they are initiator of adventures. So this is the second kind of people exist in universe. What misses here is the forethought. The action comes before the thought. They are explorers. The third kind is Nakul, who do all the sacrifices for the whole world. They are only here to offer what to take. They work on healing others, are holder of system, own pathos and sorrows. They have their own sorrows, but they don't share with people, anyone else. So here the self is missing. So they are all out for others. The fourth kind is Sahadev type, where they remain as an outsider, sitting on the fence always. You know, like when something goes wrong in the team, they say, "Maine toh bola hi tha, aisa hoga. Meri sunta kaun hai?" They are always in search. They don't belong to a particular place. They remain somewhere outside. Even at home, you have seen some such kind of people. In our offices, we have such kind of people. Everywhere we have such kind of people, and there is some element of this particular thing in every person also. Right? So action is missing here. They all talk and less action. So, however, there is a fifth type, which is Arjun. Right? So they are a mixture in the sense that they are not one particular type. They are situational. Okay, they apply all these types on a situation to situation basis. The Krishna was the fifth type of person, Arjun, Ram, all those who have actually achieved something, they are type 5. However, it is important to understand what is my core. Right? If I know that I am a Sahadev type or I am a Nakul type, then I at least know what am I, what I can do, what I cannot do, and then I can make choices. And what are those choices? The choices are whether I want to develop myself, whether I want to change something inside me, or I just want to live like that. If you can, that is a perfectly right choice. You don't need to change every time you think there is a gap, but living at peace is also a good idea. The third point in life, which is important, is acceptance. Accept the external situation and deal with it. This is also very easy said than done, because the life is, there are no straight lines in life. The straight line happens when you know, have you seen those movies where the hero's mother or hero is on the deathbed? Was screen pay that the heartbeat shows, yes, and suddenly it goes flat. Straight line is very dangerous. So straight line means we all are dead. So therefore, when we are living, there is nothing straight. So therefore, you have to accept those ups and downs in the life. Right? So that acceptance is having the faith that despite the circumstances, all is well. All may not be well, but you don't know. I think there is a famous story, you may have read it. Have you heard of that story of that farmer whose horse ran away? Have you heard of that? So I'll take 2 minutes and tell you that story.
You take 20 minutes.
So it is a Tao story of a farmer. Farmer had a horse, very healthy stallion horse, which actually used to do a lot of things for the farmer, and farmer used to earn living out of that. And one day it so happened that that horse ran away. And all the neighbors, they came saying, "Very bad, you know, it is hard luck for you, your good horse ran away." And the farmer said, "Maybe." Say, "What maybe? You know, it is a bad fortune for you." He says, "No, but maybe it is bad, maybe it is good, I don't know." So fine, after 3-4 days, what happened, that horse came back with 20 other horses from the jungle. So the neighbors again came immediately saying, wow, what a nice thing, you know, you lost one horse, you got 20 more, now you have 21 horses. So what a luck you have. The farmer said, maybe, maybe not. And then what happened? One of these days when his son was trying to ride on one of those wild horses, he fell down and broke his leg. It was a bad fracture, so the neighbors came back again saying, we are so sorry, you know, these horses, they came, but however, you know, your son got injured and the injuries are serious and it is a misfortune, bad luck for you. The farmer again said, maybe, maybe not. After about 1 week, an army came into the village, and that army was, there was a bad war going on, and the defeat was for certain. So they were looking for young people in the village, and they were recruiting every young man in the village who was healthy. But because the son of the farmer had a fracture, so he remained in the village, rest everybody had to go for the war. So life is like that. So the things which, you know, the designs of life are very different what you actually think. Many a time the situation you feel they are adverse situation, but they appear to be adverse, they are not adverse. You know, you will realize the design of life maybe later. So therefore I said, accept every situation and deal with it. It will bring peace to all of you. Fourth, very simple thing, but very difficult to practice, let me tell you. Enjoy the nature and do it every day. See, what happens at your age, there are so many things to do, but we keep thinking about work, we keep thinking about, you know, tomorrow. You know, future becomes bright, may become bright, but what about present? So it is very essential, the points I am saying is from my own experiences. Never miss a day in your life when you are not with nature. And you don't have to go to hills to actually, or to beaches to actually be closer to nature. Wherever you are, the nature is present there. Be with nature for some time, every day. It's extremely important. Point number 5. Life. Explore and learn to learn. The biggest mistake we commit is we start or assume that we will learn without learning how to learn. This is whatever little I know about Sikh religion, I think this is the premise. They say Sikh is means seekhna. So a true Sikh is the one who knows how to learn. Because learning never ends. Right? And what happens, it is not about a good teacher who is responsible for our learning. It is not about the resources which are available for our learning. It is all about our own will. Once we decide that I want to learn something, we can learn. It is like the story about Eklavya. Despite the fact that there was no teacher for him, but once he decided that he wanted to learn, he could find his way to learn. And he learned that. So there is a Zen proverb which says, when the student is ready, the teacher appears. It doesn't mean that teacher prakat ho jayega. It means that, you know, you will find your way. So that is very important. You should, I learned it very late in my life, that, you know, at least have couple of your agenda, that I want to learn this one or two things. I mean, I'm not talking about the curriculum part of it. I'm talking about something extracurricular. So you decide, and once you decide, it will happen. It is magical. The decision taking is magical. Once you decide, the whole universe will actually help you in fulfill your decisions. As I said, it is easier said than done. These are five big learnings of my life. I will now tell you what were my weaknesses when I passed out in 1990, late 1990. So these were my weaknesses. So my understanding about my subject was not good. I admit that, first time. My time management was pathetic. I was unable to say no. I couldn't speak, write, English. I was full of procrastination. I used to play table tennis, but my forehand was very bad. I used to play cricket, but I couldn't hit a ball. And I was very bad at remembering the lyrics of the songs. So let me see what I am today. Nothing improved. Except for my understanding of my subject, because I rotated my job, I left engineering and came to HR. So that was also something by design. But what I'm saying is that a lot of weaknesses we have, and we live with those weaknesses. Unless we decide to change, the change doesn't happen. Right? But is there any cost of our weaknesses? Is there any cost of our weaknesses?
Yes.
But could I counter my weaknesses?
Yes.
Despite the fact that I have weaknesses?
Yes.
And that we do with our strengths. And when I counted my strengths this morning, I was not good at my understanding about the subject. But let me tell you, I passed with honors. In my times, the honors means scoring more than 75%. So I know how to score marks. I am good at making friends. I am original and honest. I am an all-rounder. I take ownership, accountability, and a good team player. I am a creative and an artist. I am good at my backhand when I play table tennis. And in cricket, many a times they take me in the team because I am a good fielder. And in 2017, I actually maintained my strength. I just realized, you know. So perhaps as a package, you know, we all are a package. So there are weaknesses, there are strengths. Many a times we only focus at our weaknesses. And we think we are not improving without doing anything about them. Obviously, if you don't do anything about them, they won't improve. But we forget about our strengths. But when you see that those strengths are there, as a package, we are able to deliver. So we all are able to actually overcome our weaknesses with our strengths. And yes, there were things which I decided to change. I could change. In the year, after about four years of passing engineering in my job, somehow I became a technical specialist also. I carry that card still, that no, I was also once designated as technical specialist. I still hold the card, do it. I was unable to deal with ambiguity. In fact, there was a tool which tests your psychometric test, which tests your ability to deal with ambiguity. I scored very poorly on that few years back, but I worked on that. And I am now able to deal with some complex situations. I was a lazy walker and I have become a runner. So these are only three things which I count, which I have tried and changed. But all those 10 other weaknesses, I couldn't do anything. Even today. Lekin kaam chalta hai. Now let's come to work life. So I remind you of my first line. Work life is very small part of your life. Never ever give it as much importance. Right? So for work life, the first thing is, I thought of comparing my times with your times. 1991, when I was in the market looking for a job, GDP growth was 1.1%, fiscal deficit at 7.61%, foreign exchange reserves 0.6 billion, which was good for 3 weeks of imports. Unemployment rate was 4%. 2017 is your time, remember. GDP is moving around 7%. There are controversies going on. Sade shape, quarter start, part, kya hoga? Fiscal deficit, half, less than half. Wow, foreign exchange reserves. So tell me, everything is relative here. So for me, achhe din to hai. A lot has changed. So when we went into the job market, and when you guys will get into the job market, I think you are, if I compare with my times, you are better off. So be at ease. Things are going to be much better for all of you. The first thing in the work life is self-employment is an option. I was talking to my friends who came to actually to the airport to actually see me. The only best advice I can give to the student is to actually do something about self-employment. If you have a choice to work for yourself, do that. Don't pick employment as your first option. I create, I take risk, I live my passion, I am an entrepreneur. This I have, you know, copied from a website. But I mean it actually. Even if you earn less, even if you struggle a little bit in the beginning, but there is no comparison between what you, if you do something on your own and the job. The other thing is, once you decided to earn, whether it is your own work or job, so there will always be a gap between what you are and what is the ideal state. For example, if I become a sales engineer or salesman, and I know myself, I am sort of introvert person, I don't like traveling, there can be gaps between what my role demands and what I am. So first thing, whatever you do as an entrepreneur or as an employee, is to identify what is the gap between what I am and what is required from me from the role. So if you have understood that, half job is done, and once you know, you can always fill the gap. The gap can be in terms of results, practices, values, beliefs, policies, deployment, expectations and actions. The role an individual chooses to play is based upon his process of making meaning out of the situation and his basis for making choices. So what happens when we decide that this is the role I want to take and this is what I am and there is a gap? So there starts the process of development or change. So what you can do is, you can develop yourself, you can change self, you can't change others, or you can change the role, means you don't change the definition of the role, but you rotate your job, like I also did many times. Or the fourth choice is stay put and enjoy. You can still live a very good life irrespective whether you match the role or not. The only thing is, you need to be happier and at peace inside. So there is no perfection, there is no best fit, everything is a myth. Right? But it is your choice. If you want to change, fine. If you don't want to change, perfectly fine. But don't crib about it. The issue is about cribbing. The issue is not about the misalignment. How important is the work? I'm not advocating that you be insensitive, but what I'm saying is that don't take it very seriously. After all, there's a whole lot of things to life but work. So when I look back and think of the issues which actually used to make me uneasy during nights in my earlier jobs, I laugh at them. You know, today, anything I am uncomfortable with, I think it is a big challenge. Tomorrow, I mean, you look back, you think that such was such a trivial thing and I was actually worried about it. And remember, everything, I think this projector also got started working where they switched it off and switched it on. So remember, everything will start working again if you switch it off and switch it on after a while, including ourselves. So, as students also, at times the brain stops working. At times, you know, we go blank. In work also it happens. Anytime that happens, just switch off yourself. And when you switch it on, 99% chances it will work. It will work very well. So the fifth thing is, learn to be effective. Now it is also very, such a simple thing to say. But you know what? It doesn't happen. At least it hasn't happened with me. I've been trying for some time. For years actually. I want to be very effective. I want to work for less hours and do more. I am trying, still trying.
Keep on.
I checked with a lot of wiser people and they say the meditation helps. So I believe them. I am trying that also. Maybe it will work. But I haven't found any formula for this. But I have seen people who are more effective in, they work for less hours, but they do more and they are more effective. You also explore, if you can find some way, very good. Because you get time to do more other things, if you are there. Learn to enjoy. Many a times I have seen, you may also see a lot of articles are written, a lot of discussions happen, work-life balance, etc., etc. But frankly speaking, people who, there are people who can enjoy at work also. I mean, I remember a one-liner from my ex-boss, he is from Pune only, so he used to say, I worked in Suzlon. In Suzlon we used to have 7 day week, sorry, 6 day week, and then they made it second and first and third Saturday was made as holiday. So we had extended weekends or 5 day week twice a month. My boss said, you know, we thought we will do all Saturdays off, but then we realized that there will be more life and the work life balance will get destroyed. So, the point I am trying to make is that the life is also at work. So, if you enjoy what we are doing, I mean the work-life balance will not haunt you. So, you have friends at work or wherever you start working. Give and take help, this is very important. And give your best. Let me tell you one thing. In the last 26-27 years of my working, my biggest learning is that the business issues, whatever problem the business faces or the organization faces, only 5% problems are external. External means the customer related, vendor related issues are hardly 5%. 95% of the issues belongs to internal, interpersonal issues. Unfortunately, a lot of our curriculums, we don't talk about that 95% part. We only talk about the 5%, how to actually sell, how to do marketing, how to do operations, how to manufacture, etc., etc. But that 95% part, 95% of the problems are because of the interpersonal issue. So those interpersonal issues can be solved by the second line which I have shown here, give and take help, which is basically collaboration. As human beings, if we learn to collaborate, our workplaces will become 2000 times more efficient. But we don't learn. So finally, you can't do a good job if your job is all you do. So all work and no play. That is what I am trying to say here. Life is wonderful, you know. that when you live 60 years, 70 years, 80 years, and by the time you reach about 60, 50, 50 to 60, you will realize that you have not lived the life the way you want to. Right? So you are at a juncture where, you know, it is up to you to decide how much importance you want to give to your life and how much importance you want to give to your work. Accordingly, live a life which you can enjoy. So I rest my case here. Thank you so much. Spoken about anything about the emerging technologies, anything about the disruptions, anything about the VUCA world, or anything about, you know, how corporate expects stuff from you. However, based upon whatever you have heard about my experience, if you have any questions, I will be very happy to talk to you. Thank you so much.
Before thanking you, sir, we would like to ask for a sincere apology for the inconvenience caused due to technical issues. Sir, we thank you for sparing your valuable time and being a part of this National Business Convention and sharing your personal experiences with us. What we have learned from you from your lecture is that we should focus on learning and groom ourselves to add value to the industry. Sir, we also take away from this lecture for us is the difference between work life and life, and how important one's life is. And last but not the least, we should learn to learn.